Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sharmee Divan and I am here to talk about bachelor therapy and retirement. A little introduction on me. I am currently a bachelor therapy teacher in training from the BAT Center. I'm also a registered practitioner with them. Apart from that, I am a coach, I am an angel therapist and soon to be established launched author. I got into bachelor therapy approximately 6 years ago and haven't looked back ever since. I represent the Bach International Education Program of UK here in India. So we organize the international workshops over here, and we also, some of us are now teachers as well. A little understanding of the remedies and how it is going to flow for us, just so that we have an idea what we are looking at in this session. So Dr. Bach was a physician, he was a homeopath, he was a bacteriologist. His research in the bowel nozzles is very, very known in the field of medicine. And he was himself detected with cancer, given about 6 months to live. And he went on to live for a decade after that. And while he was alive, he was very inspired by Dr. Hahnemann, the father of homeopathy, and his research. And he began to look at nature for resolution. One of his popular quotes is that it's very natural, you know, if I'm hungry, I'll go to my garden and pick a lettuce. And if I have fear, I will use the remedy of mimulus. I'm not quite quoting him, but that's what he really meant. That bachelor therapy is so easy and it is so natural that anybody can take it, that anybody can use the system for their own well-being. Anyone can help their own family and friends as well. And no knowledge or no particular qualification is required for you to be practicing the remedies as such. Having said that, a basic knowledge of the remedies is very important. If you are interested in reading up on the literature of bach flower remedies, you can go on to the bach flower, so batcenter.com, www.batcenter.com, and they have a free download section, so you can download the two books that Dr. Bach wrote, the Heal Thyself and 12 Healers, and you can access it for free and you can read it, and you can always take a look and see, oh, these are the remedies that I need, and make up a mixing bottle for yourself. Yeah, so Dr. Bach, in his journey of discovering the remedies, started off with about 7 remedies and then went on to 12 and then went on to 19, and he completed the set at 38 remedies plus one more, which we know as the rescue remedy or the crisis mix. And this particular remedy is a combination of the 5 bach flower remedies that were already discovered. So there's a little story about it. I'm not going to bore you with that, but it is a set, it is the only set combination of remedies that we use that was discovered by Dr. Bach, and there's a reason why those 5 remedies are in that mix, and they're known as the rescue or the crisis mix. To make the understanding of the remedies simpler, what he did was he divided the remedies into 2 groups. Sorry, 7 groups, and these are the 7 groups. So the first one is fear, the second one is uncertainty, the third one is insufficient interest in present circumstances, the fourth one is loneliness, the fifth one is oversensitivity to influences and ideas, people who get easily influenced. The sixth one is despondency and despair, and then the seventh one is overcare for the welfare of other people. And the remedies are divided into these 7 groups, so all 38 of them belong to one group or the other. So it kind of makes our understanding of the remedies so much more simpler. So coming to our topic, so what I plan to do for our talk is that perhaps get some idea on you know, retirement and what it means to retire and what is life like after retiring and how the remedies can help us be better retired people. Yeah, so can I erase this?
Yeah.
So, if you can help me understand retirement, let's look at retirement. What does it mean to retire? Are you all working, retired?
All are retired.
All are retired, yes. That's why I chose this topic, because it was of interest to me as well, because my dad is retired, but you know, he is not very well. So, and I do work with the remedies and him, and I'd like to know more about the whole feeling of retirement and what life is like after that. So what happened when you retired? Like how long ago did you retire?
Still starting at 64.
Yeah, so it's your early retirement process. Yeah, so so can we say it safely that it is a transition, right?
Change over.
Yeah, transition. What else is retirement?
But I think it varies.
It involves a lot of things.
A lot of things, yeah.
But it involves a change of your friend circle, it involves a change of your work environment. Your work type.
Right. So changes or transitions is like the key thing, right? Yes. With retirement.
Yes. And you are required now to adopt to a new environment.
Yeah.
And continue your journey.
Yeah, so new challenges perhaps.
Yeah.
A retrospection about our lived life. Jo humne ab tak jiya uske bare mein.
Ha, uske bare mein, yeah, correct. So retrospection.
Pause and retrospection. Write a new script for second year.
Yes, I love that word, you know, second innings.
Yes,
it's always nice. I really like it. Yeah. So, second innings. Yeah. What else is retirement about?
Live your life with the fullest way, what you want to
live. Yeah.
Living the life. Fullest way.
So new goals, perhaps, yeah.
New missions, serendipity, travel, make a new friend circle, create some new things, again giving the society, leave the legacy for our children.
New friends, okay.
Contributions to our society.
Yeah.
जो अब तक लिया सब लौटा लेंगे.
That is so sweet. I like that. I really like that. Let's look at the challenges that you could have in all of these new things that come about when you retire. What about the transition or the change? What is the challenge over here? सबसे पहले तो ये है कि आप काम नहीं कर रहे हो. आप घर पे हो शायद से, है ना? Like if you are newly retired, so like the question mark. So at this point, some people are not able to cope with this transition. Yeah, a lot of people face a challenge in coping with the concept of retirement. They feel like अब तो हम कुछ काम के नहीं रहे. They feel like अब पैसा जितना है वो काफ़ी है कि नहीं, पेंशन टाइम पे आएगा कि नहीं. जो भी चैलेंजेस है आपके, यू नो द न्यू चैलेंजेस दैट यू फेस समवेयर दे आर ऑफकोर्स कनेक्टेड. या सो फाइनेंस कुड बी अ चैलेंज. फाइनेंसेस, you're not going to like work, like whether you're a businessman or whether you did a job, you were not working, so no work.
Health also.
Yeah, health, yes. Health. Health which comes with aging. What else could be there?
Fast change. We are not able to adopt in that way.
Yeah, so adopting
speed change आ रहे हैं, उस speed से बदल नहीं पाते.
हाँ, so adopting to change, adopt to it and adapt to it. It's both, right? First you have to accept it and then you have to live it. Yeah. The second innings, what about the second innings? Could be a challenge. Definitely health. Friends and family who might be, you know, dying, so could be loss of loved ones, maybe.
Yes.
Loss. Because that happens much more when you're older versus when you are younger, right? By the law of nature. What about new goals? So some people that I have met who have retired or are at a point where they are retiring, they have a plan of action. Oh, you know, once I retire, ये NGO join करेंगे, यहाँ पे ये club join करेंगे, ये hobby है मेरा जो मुझे इतने सालों से करने को नहीं मिला, तो मैं ये करूँगा, वो करूँगा, ये करूँगी, मतलब friends के साथ ज़्यादा बाहर जाऊँगी, shopping ज़्यादा कर लूँगी, so whatever. So perhaps you don't have a goal. No goal. Yeah, no goals. Perhaps no clarity. Right? What about new friends? What would you say about new friends? How are they? Exactly, difficulties in friendship, because you are not very adjusting, you are, you know, getting older, perhaps you are set in your ways, so difficult.
Old paradigm shift.
Yeah, difficult to make friends. Because you're perhaps set in your own ways. I'm not saying you are, but you know, in general, yeah, the population. Yeah. What about?
The worst thing is that a feeling is that one is no longer needed.
Yeah, yeah. So that would be a new challenge, wouldn't it be? A new challenge where you're no longer needed, not good enough. Yeah. What about when you go into retrospection? Perhaps you might feel वो भी क्या दिन थे जब हम काम करते थे, जब शाम को चाय ताज़ी ताज़ी बनती थी और उसी की महक से हम entrance मारते थे घर में. Yeah, yeah. Missing your past. Missing your past and perhaps even going back to your past.
Back to basics,
we can make this title. Yeah. Yeah, so you have a nostalgia, don't you? Yeah. Anything else you might want to add?
There is another part also about the nostalgia.
Yeah.
Sometimes you start wondering.
Yeah.
That there are roads which you should not have taken and you do. There are roads which you have taken and you have not taken.
Yeah. So perhaps some regret? Some regret, yeah.
Some kind of regret or guilty feelings.
Yes, regret. Regret, yeah, or maybe guilt.
Kaash.
Correct. Correct. Yeah, absolutely. What else? Anything else that you can think of?
Sharmee, what is
so many things?
Yeah, and you can tell me, because there are remedies that can help you with every challenge that you face in the process of retirement or as a retired individual, you know, which can perhaps work and get you your zing back for life. And maybe you are not that kind of person, but you probably know people that you can help with the use of these remedies and make them feel better about themselves. A lot of people retire and it is seen that they get depressed, they fall into depression, dementia, bipolar depression, they could probably end up committing a suicide. So life can get pretty difficult for some individuals post-retirement. So although there are some amazing things about retirement, these challenges can oftentimes hinder people from looking at the brighter side of life. As you said, second innings. I personally would love to call it second innings, because then you've done your jobs, you've done your duties and you're good to go and just have some fun. But not everyone sees it the way we see it. Yeah. So are we good with our challenges? Yeah. So let's look at some remedies for these kind of challenges, and I'll tell you a little bit about each so that you can connect with what I'm saying. Yeah. Let's look at the first one, and I would somewhere highlight this remedy and put it in this big circle, which I call walnut. Walnut is a remedy of transitions. You know, your body is changing as you are aging. Your life has probably changed. Your role in the society is changing as you retire. Respect bar jati hai. Some people cannot take that. Kabhi kabhi kisi ko lagta hai, hai meri koi respect nahi rahi because I don't work anymore. So it could be both ways. Yeah, and the star remedy in this case would be walnut. And it will help you, well, any person who is retired or is in the process of retiring, it would help them transition in a much smoother way into the whole retirement process. And also perhaps make them feel comfortable with it. Yeah. Another one that could happen here is gentian. So gentian is a remedy. Gentian. So gentian is a remedy that helps you overcome a setback in life. If you are perceiving it to be a setback, it helps you overcome that in a more efficient way. No, like, okay, yes, I have retired, but my second innings is about to start. So it kind of gives you that hope and makes you look forward to it. Some people can feel pretty hopeless and maybe gorse would help them. People who feel pretty depressed about the thought of retirement and they feel hi life khatam ho gayi ab to kuch bacha hi nahi hai ab to bas you know wo kya wo bhajan bhojan bhajji so they are like not looking forward to life, that perhaps they've lost the zing to life. So it would, you know, help them move forward to their second innings. So this over here, once again I'm highlighting, would be gorse or it would be gentian. For them to look forward to the second innings. Yeah. Let's look at the challenges that people face when they are retiring or in the process of retirement. Finances, of course, that's a very physical thing. But once again, here we are kind of going back to the transition bit, and the person says, oh, no work. What do I do now? So sometimes a person might feel apathetic, like can't be bothered, kuch bhi karo, mast mola, like they don't have any direction as such, and they perhaps don't even want direction. And this is where wild rose comes in. Where they're not having work and they're feeling pretty apathetic towards life. For aging process, once again, it's all about acceptance. So acceptance would again be walnut. The other remedy that can help in the aging process, because you get tired more easily, olive is a great remedy for fatigue. It gives you the energy. It keeps you energized. Olive. Yeah. It's a fatigue remedy where you can have that energy to get through the day. And then the other fatigue remedy that can help would be hornbeam. I'm going to write it somewhere. Okay. And hornbeam is a remedy where you don't feel like really even starting your day. I'm sure we all have those moments, whether retired or not. We oftentimes have the Monday morning blues. We don't want to start our day. And hornbeam is a great remedy to get that energy and to jumpstart your day. But then olive helps you overall with your energy levels. Let's look at not feeling good enough. When you don't feel good enough, what do you need?
Emotions.
Yeah.
The simple meaning is, am I in a position to face this challenge?
Yeah. Am I good enough? Yeah. So what goes on in the mind? Perhaps a confusion, or is it more like, oh, I'm just like really bad and I'm good for nothing? Yeah.
More of it is self-doubt.
Yeah, self-doubt. So when you have self-doubt, we have a bunch of remedies that can help you with it. One of them is willow.
Willow.
If you are feeling pretty sorry for yourself.
Oh,
It's common, yeah. It's a bach flower, yeah. So willow is when you feel sorry for yourself, that, oh, poor me, I'm not good enough.
Not capable.
Yeah. Once again, going back to walnut, that keeps you protected in your own energies, wherein you can stand strong for yourself. So this kind of works on like a bunch of combinations of remedies, the whole I am not good enough feeling. But oftentimes I have seen it comes out of feeling sorry for yourself. Yeah, a person is feeling bad for themselves, that oh poor me, I'm not good enough. Yeah, the other remedy, final one, would be large. That gives you the confidence to feel good enough. So my suggestion always would be the combination of three remedies, again depending on individual to individual as to exactly why are they not feeling good enough. Have they lost the confidence? Are they feeling sorry for themselves? Are they not feeling very safe about the retirement process? And according to that, I would choose remedies for them. Retrospection, here I would always put up a star remedy, which is honeysuckle. This is the remedy that brings you back to the present. No, like from going from hamare zamane mein, hamare dino mein, where you're constantly having a point of reference in the past, it brings you in the present. It helps you not miss the past to a point where you are stuck in it. It helps you adapt, once again, along with walnut. Yeah. Let's say you are feeling regret or guilt that, oh, had I, kash, the kash feeling, a great remedy for that would be pine. Pine. That helps you overcome the guilt or the regret that you might be feeling at the point of retrospection in your life. Now let's go back to the bright side, the second innings. Here you could be facing loss of loved ones. Very often than not, you know, parents are dying, friends are dying, family members are dying. And one remedy for this would be Star of Bethlehem. It's a comfort remedy. It's a remedy given for those who might be grieving. Sometimes you could be just feeling a gloom and you don't even know why you're feeling that gloom. You're not quite sure, but it's just one of those off days. But you can't quite figure out why. If that is the story, a great remedy for this would be mustard. It's just for those gloomy days where you have no idea why you're feeling kind of a day. Let's look at new goals. Where a person has no goals, no clarity. Once again, we come back to wild rose. Wild rose. Wild rose here as well, but this is a fairly temporary thing. This could be a more long-term thing where you're feeling very apathetic, where you have complete loss of direction. And sometimes you could be making a whole lot of goals but not going anywhere. कल जाएंगे परसों जाएंगे यू आर प्रोक्रास्टिनेटिंग यू आर प्रोक्रास्टिनेट अच्छा बैंक में जाना है कल जाएंगे परसों जाएंगे उसके बाद जाएंगे नेक्स्ट मंथ चले जाएंगे. अ ग्रेट रेमेडी फॉर दैट वुड बी वाइल्ड ओट. या वाइल्ड ओट, Yeah, wild oat. Oat. O-A-T. Yeah, like the oats that you eat. Wild oat. It's a very wild growing plant in Great Britain. Found just about anywhere. And then finally we come to new friends. And you could have difficulty making friends. So some people can be pretty reserved and can't connect to people. There is a beautiful remedy, it's called water violet. And a lot of these remedies actually follow something known as the doctrine of signature. And what that basically means is that the way that the flower behaves in nature, or way that the plant behaves in nature, that's exactly the reason why it is used as a remedy. So a water violet plant, it literally like is a long stem flower growing in a marsh where there's a whole lot of life around it, but it grows all by itself on a long stem. Just by itself. No, water violet. Yeah. And what it will help you do is, it will help you somewhere be able to find the connection again with people that you choose to connect with. It's a connection remedy. It helps you reconnect. Any other thoughts that you might have looking at this little mind map that we've drawn?
If we have growth mindset, mindset is the problem across the world.
Yeah.
When I relate it, I'm parking it, these thoughts, again connect. It is all about one law of universal nature.
Yeah.
Law of farming.
Law of farming, farming. Yeah.
What you are seeding, what you are watering, how you are nurturing,
yeah,
how you keep sunshine, how you protecting.
Correct.
It will bloom out in that way.
Correct.
Suddenly you are sowing all the negative seeds, negative procedures, negative habits,
habits,
envy, regret, jealousy, comparison, labels, anything. And after that times, you are expecting the flower will come, the good fruit will come. How it possible?
Yeah.
Mother Nature never deviates her established rule. So when you set your mindset after that time, it will come finally, aging. So first sow the right seed.
Yeah.
If you want to collect all the
fruit,
of flowers and good things. It is simple.
Correct.
No exception at all.
Correct.
Yeah. Sari mene. Simple. You can't give me across the planet single one tablet for 1 rupees. Because I would ask you why you are giving me. But I maintain this health since 1986 to still.
Correct.
With nature's procedure.
But you see, somebody
simple
like you may not need the remedies at all. Whereas there are so many people in this group that is not really talked so much about. People are somewhere, and the reason why I even came up with this topic was this, that it's a fairly ignored group in so many health sciences. Theek hai, pill de do theek ho jayenge, pill de do theek ho jayenge. Here we're looking at nature for solution. Here we are looking at nurture for solution. When the nature nurtures you, you have no choice but to bloom naturally like a flower, you know. So when we're looking at certain remedies for certain challenges that retirement brings along, perhaps I'm too young to talk about retirement, but I have seen people who are retired. I don't get very many clients who are retired and need the help and will come for help. And my thought of bringing this topic here is to encourage people to look at the options that they have in the form of batch flower remedies that can help them retire better and live a good second innings, better, more efficiently with the same zinc that they have lived their youth. And that is my sole purpose of having this lecture all together. So yeah, I'm wondering if you have any questions regarding this particular topic or the remedies that I've talked about. Any clarity you would like on it? Further clarity, further questions at all? Exactly.
The problem with that remedy is most of the stars
are
alien, foreign to the Indian
country. No. They're very much available in every homeopathic pharmacy that you can get to. It doesn't matter whether you're in the suburbs, whether you're in town, whether you're in a different city. If there is a homeopathic pharmacy, homeopathic supply shop in your area, you will find it. Zoroastrian has it, Raw has it, Roy has it, couple of other homeopathic pharmacies that are there in Mumbai definitely have the batch flower remedies because they are a part of the homeopathy system. It's just that I am very well versed with the system, although I'm not a homeopath, I am a batch flower therapist and I do have the expertise in these. But homeopaths use batch flower remedies anyways. So they are very, very accessible. Although the flowers may not grow here, the remedies are very much available. And I really hope that the audience watching the video will, you know, get something out of it because if you are looking at local remedies, go ahead and go to these pharmacies, take a look at the remedies that you need and go ahead and give it a try. Once again, thank you so much for joining. This is Sharmee Divan.
Thanks.
Thanks.